Hey there! Today we are going to sculpt a diamond. Please create a new collection, call it Diamond, then hit Shift A, Image and Reference. Choose the file that you want to use. If you need the reference image for the stone, you can download it in the description, but of course you can find those stone schematics also online in various varieties. Center the pig so that the stone is exactly in the center. Go to the object data properties and turn transparency on so you can see your grid and your axes. The cool thing about reference images is that they don't show in the render. It's just there for you to be able to model from. Everything ready and set? All three sketches perpendicular to each other and sitting beautifully in your viewport? Great job! Okay, let's go to the next step, which is, of course, the modeling itself. Start by hitting 7 on your numpad to look at the sketch from above. Hit Shift A, choose Mesh and Circle. This is just a circle without any faces inside. It only consists of vertices. Now on the left side, you see this little menu where you can specify the different settings for your circle. If you can't see your circle right now, choose Align to View. Then it should lie flat before you. The important point here is to reduce the number of vertices. The top part of the stone, which is called the table, has 8 corners. And so we are going to create 8 vertices. Then we are going to do exactly the same again with Shift A, Mesh and Circle. This should reproduce the circle now with less vertices. And then you can scale it directly in the left menu. We're going to set this circle to have 16 vertices. Just make a new collection for the three sketches. After tidying up a bit, select the outer circle and hit Tab for Edit Mode. We're now going to extrude a new ring of verts with E. We're going to combine some of those vertices. To do this, select 2 vertices. Then hit M. And then you can choose where you want to merge them. The last vertices that you will have selected will be marked white, so choose at last, and both vertices match in the position of the last vertices you selected, then only one vertice is left. Do this with every second pair of vertices here. Once you've done that, tap to object mode again, select both objects, and hit Ctrl+J. Even though they are not yet connected, if you now switch to edit mode again, you can select both the vertices from the outer as well as the inner ring, and also combine them. And that's exactly what you're going to do. Select 3 vertices and hit F to create a new face between them. Next are the faces with the 4 vertices between the outer and inner ring. Hit Alt+Z again, and then you can actually see the faces that you've created. Yeah, maybe I should have done this before. Now press 2 for edge selection mode, and then you can use C to select all 4 edges nearly at once by just putting the circle inside. You can deselect with middle mouse button, and you can exit the circle selection mode with escape. We'll also need a giant face in the center of the stone, which will form the table. Usually it's best to aim for quads in Blender. That means faces with 4 vertices around them. Mainly because it makes subdivision much easier. On my screen, you can see the difference between subdividing with quads and subdividing with trees. Also, some other techniques are way easier with quads, like texturing and UV mapping. But in this case, we are building a diamond. It can have sharp corners and sharp edges, so we can build faces with however many or little vertices we want. Once you created the center face, keep it selected. Now we are going to give the stone its 3-dimensional shape. I first tried this with proportional editing. See this little icon up here? And this means that the vertices are influenced by the ones that I am moving, indicated by this big circle. But then I realized that this would give the stone a shape that I didn't really want. So I turned it off again and just moved the center face with G and Z. Until the face was where I wanted it. And I also selected those other vertices in between, the table and the girdle, and moved them also up a bit with G and Z. So the shape of the stone would be approximated as exactly as possible. Select all the bottommost vertices with Alt left mouse button, hit E, and pull them out. Once you have the lower ring of vertices selected, go to Select and choose Checker Deselect. If the wrong ones get deselected, try making another vertice, the active vertice. The ones matching the illustration should be selected, and you can pull them down by using E and Z, and combine them with M, and choose Center. Then we subdivide the edges that we have just created with Ctrl-R. And this will create a new vertice on each of those edges. Watch out that you actually hit one before using Ctrl-R, or otherwise you won't see your newly created vertice. In Edge mode, the edges will still look the same. You can just select the halves of them separately. Now you can close up the diamond by creating new faces. I'm doing this similar to as in the beginning by selecting three vertices and hitting F. A neat little time saver is if you click the first and then Ctrl click the last, which could form a face with the first one, then all of them get selected, so you can just hit F to close them up. And then onto the last bit of the diamond. Switch once more to side view. Select those vertices in the center and then double tap G. And those will slide down along the edges. You can pull them down a little bit more to match the sketch more closely. Now we only need to close the bottom of the diamond up. And that is basically the shape of the diamond nearly completed. The only thing that's still missing is rounding the outer girdle of the diamond a bit. So let's embrace the diamond cutter inside us and polish those off. Create another circle. Give it around, let's say, 64 vertices. Scale the circle down a bit. Tap to edit mode. Hit E, scale outward. Select all and extrude it again. Now we have this giant cylindrical segment. We're now going to cut this segment from the stone. Select the stone, choose modifier. Choose Boolean, difference should already be selected. And then you can just use the eyedropper tool to select our giant cylinder. Once the bool mod was in place, I singled out my diamond by hitting slash on my numpad. I'm not really sure if this is the default shortcut, but you can go to Edit, Preferences and Keymap. And there you can type local and change your preferred keystroke for a local view. Quick and easily. And you can see that the Boolean modifier has polished off our girdle very nicely. To make the polishing permanent, I apply the Boolean modifier and I also delete the cylinder. That looks like a real diamond to me. And you have reached the end of the class. I hope you're really happy with what you created. And if you want to learn more about jewelry design with Blender, I highly invite you to take my class on Skillshare, for which, of course, you can find the link in the description, including 2 weeks of Skillshare Premium for free. Best wishes and see you in my next video.